Okay, good afternoon. We are here to announce today that the investigation into the Winchester murder is now complete. We are releasing the video footage at the airport today. Just want to let everybody know that we did check with the family before we did this. We offered them the opportunity to review the video before it was released to the public. But obviously, we've received several open records requests for this video. In the video, you're going to see several pieces of footage. What we have confirmed is that the suspect arrived to the airport on the 11th, on November 11th. He is seen in the video pulling in his red truck, going up to the second story parking garage and parking his vehicle. It became very obvious to us that he intended to find and keep that parking spot because he'd never moved his vehicle after that. Once he parked on the second floor facing the east side where the victim would be walking, that's where the vehicle remained. He is seen on that particular day, arrive, park his vehicle, then walk down through the garage towards the terminal. At some point, at approximately 5:40 p.m., he is seen leaving the Will Rogers World Airport in a taxi cab. He arrived at 1:47 on that same day. The video also shows him come back to the airport on the 15th, so basically 4 days later, at about 10:19 a.m., he is seen arriving to the airport in a taxi and then walking towards the location where his vehicle was parked at approximately 10:24. The victim, Mr. Winchester, was seen walking towards his vehicle at approximately 12:46, and that's roughly around the time that we believe he was shot. Basically what we determined is that a single shot was fired by the suspect at the victim, killing him. The video also shows several individuals trying to revive the victim, giving him CPR, calling IMSA, when the victim was transported to an area hospital where he was officially pronounced deceased. Approximately 35-40 minutes later, a second shot is heard. We do not have video footage of this, just basically some of the camera audio did catch a second muffled shot. We believe that this shot was from a handgun and it was a suspect killing himself. Basically, based off of the video evidence, information for witnesses, the investigation into the employment history of the suspect, we believe that this was obviously an intentional, premeditated act. The suspect intended to go to the airport, find a location in the parking lot on the east side, facing where he knew that the victim was going to be walking. We still don't know for certain, with 100% certainty, whether the victim, Mr. Winchester, was the intended victim. It may have been that he was looking for any supervisor from that worked for Southwest, but unfortunately, that's how it transpired. Going back to the evidence found, basically a handgun and a high-powered rifle was found in the truck. The high-powered rifle did have a very sophisticated scope. Therefore, a shot of about 60 yards would not have been very difficult for somebody who is trained to use a rifle. Secondly, we did find some additional firearms and bullets and rounds for these firearms in his home when his home was searched. That basically concludes our investigation. Any questions?
So the video shows him walking out. So did he come and leave in those 4 days that you know of?
You know, what we know for certain is that he showed up on the 11th. He's seen walking through the garage after he parked his vehicle, walking towards the terminal. And we know that he leaves on the 11th. We don't see him come back until the 15th. There is some movement through the garage, through the terminal area where he was walking to and from the taxi, but that's all that we have. So we don't have any evidence that he was there in between on the 12th, 13th, or 14th.
Did he also arrive in a taxi on the 15th?
Yes. The first time he arrived on the 11th, he arrived in his own truck and parked it. When he came back on the 15th, he came in a taxi. Did you have a question more?
Why would he leave?
Well, it is believed that really that spot from the second floor of the parking garage facing the east was his best spot, tactically, to take a shot at somebody walking to and from the terminal to the parking lot.
Did your investigation determine what he was doing in those 4 days? Was he living a normal life, or was there anything to indicate that something might happen?
Well, we have reason to believe that maybe he knew that specific people were going to be there a few days later. Hence the reason why he did not come back after the 11th until the 15th. But other than just going back home and being at home, we don't have any more information related to the crime of what he was doing.
You said that you didn't know if Winchester was exactly the intended target. Do we know if they worked together at their time at Will Rogers World Airport?
Yeah, we know they worked together, but we also know that he had contact with several of the supervisors, and obviously his departure from that employment was not pleasant for him. So we can't say with 100% certainty that it was Mr. Winchester he was waiting for. Again, he may have been waiting for anybody with authority, anybody that he disliked. That may have been an intended victim. It just happened to be Mr. Winchester. So we can't say for sure he may have been the intended victim. He may not have been.
Can you confirm for us, why was he left?
Well, that's really information that I would prefer that you confirm through Southwest. But the information is already out there that he was at the airport. He was found to be under the influence of alcohol, was believed, and he was offered a breath test. He walked away from the job after that. And didn't come back, so they considered that a resignation.
Tomorrow marks 1 month since the shooting happened. Is there any sort of closure to the family?
Well, number one, it's an extremely sad situation for everybody involved. We give our condolences on the day of the homicide, and we give them now. We know that's something that's not easy to get past. Also, it's a month later, and now we're releasing the video. Quite frankly, we delayed as long as we could because we had an open investigation, but now that it's closed, really there's no reason for us to legally withhold the video, so we're releasing it now. And our sincerest apologies to the family. We don't mean for this to cause any type of harm to them, obviously, but this incident is obviously very high in the attention of the media and the public, and they want this information.
Was there anything in those 4 days between when he first arrived and when the shooting happened that could have tipped off security, that could have alerted someone?
Really, no. Unless somebody spotted him. Keep in mind that this was approximately a year and a half after he left the job. So really, at that point, there's no reason to have any type of be on the lookout or bulletin for this individual. Quite possibly, if somebody would have seen him and saw that he was acting strangely, they could have alerted police. But I mean, keep in mind, thousands of people go through that airport on a daily basis. There's thousands of cars in the garage. It's very, very typical for people to park and leave their car for 2 weeks. I mean, that's not out of the ordinary. So there wasn't a whole lot of suspicious information that the police could have followed up on.
So is there anything that could be changed in the future to prevent something like this, or is this unpreventable?
Well, keep in mind that this is the first time in the history of the airport that something like this has happened. So it's not something that happens frequently. It's not something that's a huge issue. It happens to be one individual who, out of selfish reasons and criminal reasons, committed a very heinous crime that hurt and touched a lot of people. What's not to say that, obviously, it's up to the airport to review their protocol for emergencies such as this, but really there's not a whole lot more you could have done other than just have hours and hours of delay time for anybody who goes in and out of the airport.
And your investigation basically concluded that you worked alone, you don't think you worked with anybody?
We have no reason to believe that he conspired with anyone to commit this crime. We believe he did act alone.
And there was no, over that year and a half that he was not employed there was no threats towards any supervisors or anyone?
Not to my knowledge, and not through our police department.
And there was a 35-minute period where before he killed himself. Mm-hmm. There was in the video, you see a lot of people down there, around him. So I mean, this could have ended a lot worse as well.
Right? It could have. I mean, he definitely had the opportunity to continue shooting at people. I can tell you that the police officers who were on the scene very quickly looked up to the second level and identified that second level as pretty much the perfect spot to commit this type of crime. So we were very quickly alerted. What he did was he went back inside his vehicle and basically remained in there until he found the courage to kill himself.
Was he under the influence of anything when he committed the crime?
I did not receive that information. Alcohol was found inside the vehicle, so that's a possibility, but I did not receive a toxicology report.
And then basically, what does this mean that it's complete when you guys, in a situation like this, the shooter's obviously dead, mm-hmm. but what does it mean now for you guys when you guys complete an investigation like
well,
this?
Obviously a murder investigation is very, very important. It's very important for us to investigate this completely and fully. You know, it would have been very easy to say, look, the suspect's deceased, the victim's deceased, there's not a whole lot more we can do, but that's not always the case. We may have been able to find out an accomplice, and we may have been able to find out plans for how he carried this out so we can make improvements, and really nothing like that was revealed. The only thing we did do is conclude and confirm some of the information that we suspected.